Hi students, in this video we are going to discuss magnetic moment of an electron and also we are going to prove that bar magnet act as a solenoid. Now in the previous chapter I told you Christian Oersted proved that moving charges or current produces magnetic field, and we all know that in an atom electrons revolve around the nucleus. So electron is a charge, so definitely there will be a magnetic field or a magnetic moment associated with the electron. So we are going to find out what is the magnetic moment of electron revolving around the nucleus, and also we are going to define two new ratios in this video. So let us start. So for this we consider the case of a hydrogen atom. We know that a hydrogen atom consists of an electron, and this electron revolves around the nucleus like planets revolve around the sun. So this is our nucleus of charge ZA, and electron is revolving in anti-clockwise direction. Now in which direction electron is moving, the current will be flowing in the opposite direction. So let current be flowing in the clockwise direction. Let V be the orbital velocity of the electron. Now we know moving charge constitute a current, so the current produced by the movement of electron is given by I is equal to E divided by, we are taking one complete revolution, so I divided by capital T. Now next what we are going to do is we are going to convert our equation I in terms of velocity V, radius of the orbit R, and charge of the electron. So we have studied the equation omega is equal to 2 pi f. Now this can be written as 2 pi, instead of f I am going to write 1 by t. And also the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity is given by v is equal to r omega. So instead of omega I am going to substitute 2 pi by t, so we get r into 2 pi by t, or time period t is equal to 2 pi r divided by v. Next I am going to substitute the value of t in the equation of I, so I get I is equal to 2 pi EV divided by 2 pi R. Now this is the current flowing through our orbit, amount of current flowing in our orbit due to the motion of the electrons. But our aim is to find out the magnetic moment. Now we know the equation of magnetic moment for a circular loop, current carrying circular loop, is M is equal to I into A, where I is the current and A is the area of the loop. Now in the case of electron, instead of M we denote by magnetic moment with the alphabet mu e. So you can write mu e is equal to IA, which is equal to, now what is the value of I? EV divided by 2 pi R. So we can write EV divided by 2 pi R into A. Now what is the area of a circular loop? It will be pi R square. So into pi R square. Cancel the common terms. We get the orbital magnetic moment of the electron as mu L is equal to E V R divided by 2. Now, this is the orbital magnetic moment possessed by an electron due to its motion. Next, we are going to define a new term which is known as the gyromagnetic ratio. Gyromagnetic ratio, and it is defined as the ratio of orbital magnetic moment of the electron to the angular momentum of the electron L. Orbital angular momentum, sorry, orbital magnetic moment to the ratio of orbital magnetic moment. Now, orbital magnetic moment for an electron revolving in a nucleus is given by L is equal to mvr. Since it is an electron, we denote it by mevr. And mu L is what? Mu L is equal to evr divided by 2. So, taking the ratios, we get mu L by L is equal to evr by 2, that divided by mevr. Cancel the common terms, you get gyromagnetic ratio as E divided by 2ME. Now, we know what is the value of E, isn't it? The value of E is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb, and mass of the electron is 9.11 into 10 raised to minus 31 kilogram. So, on substituting the value, we get mu L by L is equal to 8.8 into 10 raised to 10 coulomb kilogram raised to minus 1. Now, magnetic moment has a direction. So, next we are going to find out what is the direction of magnetic moment. Now, in our case, electron is revolving in the anticlockwise direction and current is flowing in the clockwise direction. So, current is flowing in the clockwise direction. Using right hand thumb rule, if this is the direction of current, then the direction of magnetic moment will be pointing downwards, which means this will be the direction of our magnetic moment of the electron. Okay, and also orbital angular momentum will be directed opposite to the direction of orbital magnetic moment. So, orbital angular momentum will be directed towards L. So, in vector form, we can write the above equation as mu L by L is equal to E divided by 2ME, or is equal to minus E divided by 2ME into L, where the minus sign represents that the direction of L is opposite to the direction of E. We have to divide, we have to define one more term in this derivation, and that is known as the Bohr magneton. Now, Bohr magneton is the value of orbital magnetic moment of an electron revolving in a hydrogen nucleus in the first orbit. It is the value of orbital magnetic moment of the electron revolving in the first orbit of hydrogen atom. Now, We have studied the Bohr quantization condition. According to Bohr quantization condition, only those orbits are permitted in which the orbital angular momentum has a value L is equal to nh divided by 2 pi, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. And the gyromagnetic ratio is given by the equation mu L by L is equal to E divided by 2 ME. I'm going to rearrange this equation. We can write mu L is equal to E divided by 2 ME into L. Now for the first orbit, Ln is equal to 1. So I'm going to substitute the equation of L. We'll get mu L is equal to E divided by 2 ME into H divided by 2 pi. Now, where H is the Planck's constant. And on substituting the value of E, H, ME and pi, we get mu L is equal to 9.27 into 10 raised to 24 ampere meter raised to minus 1. Sorry, ampere meter square. Mu L is equal to 9.27 into 10 raised to 24 ampere meter square. Next, we are going to prove that a bar magnet is equivalent to a solenoid. Our solenoid field produced by a solenoid is similar to the field produced by a bar magnet. Now, you know what is a solenoid? It is a coil of wire. It's a coil of wire. And we connect the coil of wire to a battery. So, current will start to pass through the solenoid. And what happens? It produces a magnetic field. And we have derived the expression for magnetic field inside a solenoid. And also, this is a bar magnet. You look, this is a bar magnet. Doesn't pole, north pole and south pole. And the field lines are from north to south outside the magnet. And inside the magnet, it is from south to north. So, if you look into these two diagrams, we can see the field lines are similar. Also, if I take a bar magnet, a normal bar magnet, and divide into small pieces, then I will get a bar magnet which is producing again a magnet, which is having a magnetic field of feeble strength, but will be having a north pole and a south pole. In the same way, if I take my solenoid, if I cut into pieces, make current to pass through those pieces, current to pass through those circular coils, then each coil will produce a magnetic field. So we can say a bar magnet is similar to a solenoid, or a solenoid is similar to a bar magnet. So next, we are going to prove it using mathematical derivation. Okay, so imagine I have a solenoid. And this is the center of my solenoid. Oh, 2L is the total length of the solenoid. And from the center to the one end, the length is L. And to the other end, again, it is L, because 2L is our total length. And I'm going to find out what is the field produced at a point P, which is at a distance R from the center of the solenoid. Now this distance is R and A is the radius of a circular coil. For that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a very small portion of the solenoid having thickness dx. And I'm going to find out what is the field produced due to dx at point P. And then to find out the entire field effect, what will I do? I will integrate. So I'm going to take a very small portion of my solenoid having thickness dx. And this dx portion is at a distance x from the center of the solenoid. So R is the distance from center of the solenoid to point P. A is the radius of the coil. X is the distance from center of the solenoid to the ocean dx. In the previous chapter, we have studied the derivation for the magnetic field produced at a point along the axis of a circular coil. This the magnetic field at a point due to a circular coil along its axis is given by dB is equal to mu 0 n I a square divided by 2 into r square plus a square the whole raised to 3 by 2. This was the expression we obtained for a magnetic field produced by a circular coil along its axis. Now, I have taken a small portion of my solenoid of thickness dx. Now, I told you in the previous videos, I have told you n is the total number of turns in the solenoid. Capital N is the total number of turns. Number of turns in the solenoid, and small letter n is the number of turns per unit length, which means n dx will be the number of turns present in the region dx. Capital N is the total number of turns, small letter n is the number of turns per unit length, and n dx, small letter n dx, is the number of turns present in this region. I'm going to modify my equation. dB is equal to mu 0 n I divided a square divided by 2 into r square plus a square the whole raised to 3 by 2 in terms of n dx. And also, I am going to bring a small change in the variable r. So, in this equation, instead of capital N, I am going to write what? I am going to write N dx. And I told you for the circular coil, r was the distance from the center of the coil to the point of observation. That was r. But in our case, we are not taking the portion from the center. Dx is not from the center, it is at a distance x from the center of the solenoid. So, instead of r, I have to write r minus x. So, my above equation can be written as dB is equal to mu 0 instead of capital N, small n dx, I a square divided by, instead of r, what should I write? I should write r minus x the whole square plus a square the whole raised to 3 by 2. Now, this is the field produced at a point P due to a portion dx of the solenoid. But my aim is to find out the total field produced at point P due to the entire solenoid. So, how will you find the total field? We do integration. So, when we are integrating, we have to apply the limit. Now, 2L is the total length of my solenoid, and this is the center, then this can be considered, this length can be considered as minus L, and this can be considered as plus L. So, my limit is from minus L to plus L. So, I can write total field B at point P is equal to integral from one end to other end, that is minus L to plus L dB, which is equal to, I am going to substitute the values, we will get integral from minus L to plus L mu 0 n dx I a square divided by 2 into r minus x the whole square plus a square the whole raised to 3. Now, before applying the integration rule, what I am going to do is, I am going to do a small approximation. I am going to consider that my point R is very, very far away. so that, and it is bigger compared to the radius of the coil. So the denominator term of this equation becomes r minus x the whole square plus a square, can be written as r square. Why? Because x is a very small value and a is a very small value when we compare it with r. So r minus x whole square plus a square is written as r square. So the equation becomes b is equal to integral from minus l to l mu 0 n dx I a square the whole divided by 2 into r square the whole raised to 3 by 2 becomes r cube. Now we know that mu 0 is a constant, n dx means number of turns in that region is a constant, n is a constant, dx is a factor which is varying because thickness is what I take. So dx is the varying factor, I is the current, a is the radius of the coil, r is the distance of a point of observation distance. So these are all constants, which means I can bring all those constants outside the integral. I'll get b is equal to mu 0 I a square n by 2 r cube integral minus l to l dx. Now what is the integral dx? Integral dx is x. So this becomes b is equal to mu 0 I a square n by 2 r cube with x plus l to plus l. Now you know how to apply limits in integration. How will we apply this? Upper limit minus lower limit. I'm only taking the limit side. It is upper limit minus lower limit. So this is equal to this into upper limit minus minus l, that is 2l. So at the end I'll get b is equal to mu 0 I a square and into 2l the whole divided by 2r cube. Now again I'm going to modify this equation. So for that what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply and divide this equation. Multiply and divide this equation with 2pi. So I will get b is equal to mu 0 I n into 2l a square 2pi, pi into 2 divided by 4pi r cube. Now you know n, small letter n into total length. We know 2l is the total length of a solenoid, which means it represents capital N. So this is capital N, total number of turns in a solenoid, and also pi r square, or pi, in the case here it is pi a square, represents the area of the coil. So I can write it as capital A. So what my equation becomes? My equation becomes b is equal to mu 0 n I a into 2 divided by 4 pi r cube. Now what is NIA? NI is the magnetic moment of a circular coil. So this equation becomes B is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi 2m divided by r cube. And this equation is similar to the equation of magnetic field produced by a bar magnet along its axis. We have derived that equation in the video number 2, which means a bar magnet is equivalent to a solenoid, or a solenoid can be considered to be equivalent to a bar magnet. I hope you understood this derivation. Thank you.